A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitan Rajeem, Bismillah Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. We seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Shaitan, and we begin in the name of Allah, the Most Gracious, Most Merciful. Welcome to Ramadan Love. My name is Abdul Fattah Adeyemi. We want to look at the aspect of in the month of Ramadan that has to do with purification. And that's why we say love is pure. And to purify the love that you have and the love that you feel, there's a certain formula in the month of Ramadan that permeates the whole of the glorious Quran. And that is manifested by the institution of Zakatul Fitri. What we call Zakatul Fitri is a way of giving out alms to the poor, and that has to do with feeding somebody. It's a form of food or form of feeds that we have around us in our locality. The Zakat, the meaning of Zakat is to purify. Like the Quran says, "Qad aflaha man tazakka wa dhakara isma rabbihi fa salla." Successful indeed is one that purifies and remembers the name of his Lord and he observes salat. This tazkiyah to nafsi can be manifested or can be established through the zakat that we give. Not necessarily the zakat as a pillar of Islam, but here it is distinguished by being described as Zakatul Fitri. And that is to give to somebody. And there's something very spectacular about this. Zakatul Fitri is to be given as a food item as it is. And it also relates to feeding the needy that's always mentioned in the glorious Quran. One of the secrets of success in life is when you understand this concept and how it works. When you understand that feeling the next person is an outward expression of love of humanity and love of Almighty Allah that has institutionalized the feeding of the poor. If you observe from the glorious Quran from Suratul Fatiha through Baqarah up until when you get to Suratul Nas, you hear in many cases where Allah talk about Ta'amul Miskin, feeding the needy, feeding those who are poor, those who are needy, feeding those who need one thing or the other. This feeding that we have, it's also mentioned where Allah says, "Wa yut'imuna at-ta'ama 'ala hubbihi miskinan wa yatiman wa asira." And Allah describes those who feed other people, even when they also have need for this food. They feed the needy and they feed the orphans and those who are in need. Generally, what this does is that it removes rancor from the society. It removes envy from the society. It also helps in taming your heart. It helps in purifying your soul. To give feed to somebody in the day of hunger, that is, أَوْ يَتَعَامُنْ فِي يَوْمٍ ذِي مَسْغَبَ. Feeding somebody in the name of hunger, this is one of the best ways through which you can express love to other people. Feeding and eating is part of the things that humans do. And this is not about to change, although it has been for long since when Allah created the first human being on earth. And so many other living beings also survive by eating and by feeding. So feeding somebody else is like making yourself to be available to show the love of Almighty Allah and let it flow through you to other people. We have observed very well that allowing other people to feed through you, it's not just the human beings this time around. You also take care of the animals and you take care of other creatures all around you. So the essence of Zakatul Fitri is the tazkiyah to nafsi, is to purify your heart, is to purify your soul, and that is the best of love. You cannot tell somebody that you love and care for them and they are hungry and you do something about it. In the world today, we have a lot of people that are hungry and some people have no food to eat. When they eat in the morning, they may not be sure what to eat next in the afternoon or in the evening. So many people are hungry in one form or the other, in one place or the other. And the Prophet ﷺ said, "La yu'minu ahadukum," none of you is truly a believer, when you go to sleep and your neighbor is hungry. And this is to show us that one of the best ways to express our love and to express our iman is when we try to feed others. Let us try to do something, not to organize pity party for those who are hungry, not to pretend as if we don't see those who are struggling, not to look the other way when we see people dying of hunger, but let us lend a hand of support to those who need it. It's not only food that people need. Some people hunger for support. They hunger for love. They hunger for affection. They want somebody to listen to them. They want someone to hear them out. They want somebody to hear their own side of the story, of their struggles in life. They want somebody to relate their tales to. Maybe they can understand their stories. The hunger some people have, maybe the thirst and hunger for Iman. Some people are making efforts trying to improve themselves. They're in the process of making themselves to be useful for humanity. And they're also in the process of seeking more knowledge with which to do ibadah and worship Almighty Allah. Let us do this test clear to nafsi, purifying our souls out of love. And let us give to others whatever thing they are hungry for, especially whatever we can afford. But you know, you cannot give what you don't have. Feed yourself and feed others. It's the month of Ramadan. It's the month of love. Assalamu alaikum.